Hello guys, welcome back. By now we have completed everything that was a part of your syllabus. So in the last two videos, we shall make a small project. The project will be a student information system. I will not add all the features into it. I will include the most important ones here. And later on, you can always add new features as per your requirements. So first of all, I will write the code and then I will explain to you what the code does. I have divided this entire project into two videos. In the first video, we will focus on the interaction part, that is interaction with the user, and in the second part of the video, we shall write the database part. Database, actually, for the database, we'll be using files, okay? We will create one file into which we shall store the information entered by the user. So let's get started with the code. First of all, I will include all the header files that I'll be using throughout the code. Now I will write the function prototypes. So that is all. We have written all the necessary function prototypes. This is the main menu. We will use this function in order to display the menu to the user. AddStudent will take the information from the user to AddNameStudent. ViewStudent will view the information of the student to the user. ModifyStudent will be used to modify the details of some student. Similarly, DeleteStudent will be used to delete some student from the database. Next, we have WriteToFile. Inside this function, we will write our code using which the information entered by the user will be written into our student data file. Similarly, this update function will update some information from the file. And lastly, read from file will be used to read information from the file. Now let us prepare one structure. Inside the structures, I will use four or five fields. Okay, let's write it down first. The first field will be student ID. Next, I will take int standard. Then I'll take the student name. Let's say the size is 25. Next, I will take the date of birth of the student. Size 10. And lastly, I will take the contact number. This STU will be the object for this structure. Now I will just write this void main menu. So here I am writing the definition for the main menu function. Now, I will write the definition for the addStudent method. See, here I am using this function, that is fflushstdin. This function is used in order to clear the input buffer, because what happens is if you try to take any string input after taking the input for an integer, then the program misbehaves sometime. So in order to avoid that, I am using this fflush function. So now I'll take some inputs. In order to take the student name, I'll be using getUs function. And the same thing I will do to take the input for date of birth as well. Now I'll take the input for standard. And at the end, we have the contact number. As because our contact number was of type long long, I am writing percentage LLD. So here I'll replace it with contact number. And once I'm done with taking the inputs, I will just make a call to the write-to-file function. Obviously, we have not defined this function until now. We shall do it later on. And just to make it a little interactive, I'll use one line over here. That is, so when I use this getch function over here, it will basically wait for the student, rather wait for the user until the user presses any key. Once he presses the key, this getch function will redirect to the main menu, or rather it will exit from this function. Now I will write view student definition. Inside this, I will use one variable, that is int search id, because it is the search id using which we shall identify some student or retrieve the record of some student from the file. I'll just copy a few lines over here. This is view student. Enter ID of student to view. Ampersand search ID. Now we make a call to one function, that is read from file. Even this function we have not defined until now, but we shall soon do it. And I'm passing the search ID that we took as input, I'm passing inside this function as a parameter. Printf. Rather, what I'll do is just copy this stuff. So in order to print the student name, over here I'll write this stu.studentName, obviously a comma. Let's put a new line here, comma, new line here also, comma, stu.standard, again a new line, comma, contact number. Else printf. There is no record for student ID. Search ID. So inside this, if the record is found in the file, that we shall check using this read from file function. So if the record corresponding to the search ID is found in the student data file, then it shall print the record, I mean print the student details. Otherwise it will prompt this message, that is, there is no record for student ID, search ID, that is the search ID which user gave. And at the end, we'll just copy these two lines and paste it over here. Now I'll write the definition for modify student. Inside this function, I will take the ID of the student who needs to be, I mean, which the user wants to modify. So I'll write modify student. And again, I'll take the same input, modify ID. Inside this, flush. Again, we are making call to this function, that is flush stdin, and over here, what I'll do, I'll just copy few things. So we are taking the input from the user for the student which he wants to modify. That is, if the record of the student corresponding to this modify ID is found in the file, then we shall ask the user to enter these details. If it is not found, then we will print the same statement that we did earlier. That is, there is no record for student whose search ID, or rather whose ID is modify ID. And once we have taken all the inputs, we will write a line, printf updating data please wait. All these I am writing just to make the code a little interactive, nothing else. And over here I am making a call to the sleep function, which is defined inside windows.h, and inside the sleep function I am passing the parameter as 1000, which means the system, or rather the console, will pause for 1000 milliseconds or 1 second. And then I will make a call to this update function, which we have not yet defined. We shall do it soon. Again I will make a call to the sleep function, and after this I will write a printf, inside which I shall write slash n data updated successfully. Okay, so we are done with this method. Or rather, at the end we again have these two lines. So we are more or less done with this method. Now I'll write the main function, and inside the main function I shall present the menu to the user, or rather I'll write the switch case for the menu that we are presenting to the user. So first of all I'll take one input, that is user main menu choice. I'm taking such a big name just to make the make it understandable through the program. You can take any variable names as you desire. So I write system cls, and then I make a call to the main menu function. Over here I will ask the user to give one input. So let us say enter your choice. So I'll write scanf percentage d comma user main menu choice. Once this is done, I will write the switch. Obviously inside the switch we'll have this user main menu choice, because it is this input which user is giving, we shall be our condition shall be based upon this input. So if the user enters 1, then I will make a call to add student function, and here I'll write break. Now case 2, if the user enters 2, then we shall make a call to the viewStudent method. Case 3 is modifyStudent. Case 4 will be delete student. Case 5. In this case, I will do a little bit of things. So first I write the sleep, then I make a printf function, inside which I will write exiting. Please wait. Again, I am doing this only to make the function a little, or rather to make the program a little interactive. Again, we make a call to sleep, this time for 2 seconds. Then I write exit successful. And then I call this exit function. This exit function will just exit through this program, and it is defined inside stdlib.h. So obviously we'll break over here. And lastly we will make one case, that is the default case. So here again, sleep for say 1000, invalid choice. Once this is done, again asleep. And then I'll write, please select an option from 1 to 5. You sleep over here. Okay, so we are done with the main menu almost. Now, yeah, that is all for the main menu. And also, that is all for this video. Let's save the code. Control S. In the next video, we will write the definition for the remaining functions, that is delete student, write to file, update, and read from file. Now let us just take a look at this function, rather this piece of code that we have written until now. Over here, first of all, we wrote the header files. Then we have written the prototypes for the functions that we'll be using. We declared our structure, inside which we took few variables or identifiers. This is the definition for main menu that we will present to the user. This is the definition for the add student. Inside this, we have first taken inputs and then we are making a call to write to file function. Over here, we have the view student, in which we are first taking the input from a user, that is the search ID. And then we will search our database or our records for the search ID. If the search ID matches, then we will print these student details. If it does not match, then we print the, or rather we make a prompt. And inside modify student, again we are taking an ID of the student which the user wants to modify. If that particular ID is found in our records, then we'll again take the inputs from the user, updated inputs, and we'll make a call to this update function. And if the details of the student or if the modify ID is not present in the record, then we'll again print an error message. That was all for the functions. And lastly, we had the main function, inside which we just took one input from the user for the main menu choice that he selects, and then we wrote our switch case. Okay, so that is all for this video. Thank you. In the next video, we will do the remaining part of the code.